pushes. Dome Shield is placed, and now Dark Zero is going to be your champion Zero, of the Apex the Legends.
I had a rough split one.
A big problem for us in split one and playoffs especially was our POIs. Coming over fairly late, didn't really have time to contest properly.
I didn't play the best. I played okay, but not the best.
We thought might be hoisting the trophy for the third time though was Dark Zero, and it ended a bit disappointingly for them. They didn't get to match point, although they made it into the finals. It was the first LAN event they would show up to in the last 2 years that they did not hoist the trophy for. They moved from APAC South to North America. Can this be the time that they get back on top? A lot of questions that are gonna be asked of Jim Burton, Sharky, and Zero, but I think they can answer them.
He's gonna do it! They are your champions, Australia!
All of a sudden, we got some very interesting news of obviously Sharky not able to continue playing for Dark Zero, and that was a shocker as well. But we also saw some news across the league in a different fashion with Rambo announcing his retirement. Filling in for Sharky's absence in Dark Zero was too good to pass up. This has led us to an unprecedented return of Rambo after just 3 weeks ago retiring, and a unprecedented view of Dark Zero, two-time winners without Sharky by Zero and Jim Burton's side. What does that mean for today?
How did that just happen? Bro, how did that just happen? How the fuck are we getting walked on?
Oh my god.
Who the fuck was the team? But they're dead now.
Let me just clarify. Like, I seriously have no beef. Like, I generally love playing with them so far. Like, I have no beef. I'm just saying what I was told. That's
to play with Bo for the rest of the split and then trial people when we have time in a 2 month break after LAN and see what's going on. That's why I'm saying it's not about Bo. This is the only time until the end of LAN. We have to see if anyone else is like okay at all.
Obviously, I'd love to play with them, and that's why I did what I did and try to join them. But I mean, yeah, I mean, it's definitely timing of it is just shit. That's just really what
the most talked about one is Dark Zero having to decide between taking Rambo on or picking up a new player. And that, of course, was Zynu, who ended up joining this roster just a few days ago. Mark, this is a player who has had an incredible season and is looking to do something special with Dark Zero.
Hi, my name is Zynu, and I'm a professional Apex player for Dark Zero.
You know, they're a two-time LAN winner. They just picked up Zynu.
Gen and Zero have a lot more confidence, and, like, they just know a lot more. So anything, like, I don't know, if I mess up, they just tell me what I did wrong, you know? Just overall help me, like, get better, you know?
Just young talent. He's just, I feel like he knows what he's doing. He's a good fragger on the team. So I used to be kind of a fragger role, but I gave it to Zynu because I just knew he's young. He can just do it better.
It's pretty insane for Zynu's first split. Now he's playing so well. He's just adapting really fast, and his work ethic just helps him improve really fast.
Well, the thing with Zynu is I've been a big believer in his talent for a while now. I was telling people before this split of Pearl even started that he was probably the best unsigned player in Apex, and he's definitely showed, you know, why I had that confidence in him even, you know, before I've met him or anything.
He learned a lot faster than other players, and his raw mechanics, obviously, excellent team fighter.
I think about like what I do wrong a lot. I think how I can fix that. I mean, I'm always just trying to get better, stuff like that. Yeah, I mean, I think I'm just overall a good teammate. Like, sometimes I can get mad, but I think everyone kind of just gets mad eventually.
He's going to be successful, I think, regardless of anything. He's just got too much passion for the game and too much skill to ever not be successful. It's just about how fast we can get him acclimated, and I think he's done a really good job so far, and I'm not worried about it at all.
I feel like the addition of Nick, just the way we think about the game is quite similar, and he can help Zynu improve on a personal level as well, which is a great addition.
I'm gonna be honest, the most surprising thing about everybody on this team is the fact that they're very similar in person to how they are online. You know, a lot of guys are very different, like very outgoing online in voice chat or whatever, and then they're incredibly, you know, reserved, quiet in real life. And I mean, everybody's exactly the same. Like, Jin is probably the nicest guy you'll ever meet, and he carries that over both online.
I want to grow my stream more. I want to win a LAN, you know, that'll always be fun. That's my main goal. I just want to be known for something, you know, when I leave the game, you know, like people are like, yeah, that's a new guy who's like really good at that. Yeah, that's pretty much it.
Stop. Zynu, you are the best player in the game! You are the fucking best, cut! Let's go! Let's go!
take a shower, read a book and feel empowered. Smoking on that sour got me counting down the hours, thinking of all the shit that they could do but won't allow.
Is FC fucking real?
What was that Ben doing?
So
bro, what did
Hammer
Drill just do,
bro? I fucking own these punch
match.
Good shit.
Holy shit.
Dude, why is it still bugged? It's been a fucking month.
Yep. Classic Apex.
We actually played that game really well, though.
Good shit. What farm was that, Daniel?
I was cooking, bro.
You're cooking with the bow, bro.
I was cooking.
What the fuck is that shit?
Are you guys okay?
It's not.
Grab the end.
Oh,
that's not
that
hot.
That's not.
You're saying we
eat more than
you
are.
Yeah, because they're so thin, yeah.
In terms of contesting Aurora, they've been very consistently stubborn, and they know what POIs they want, and they're very committed to it, and I do respect them for that.
The Harvester contest in general is just horrible. It's just you're going into the middle, and whoever gets there first gets a gun. Wins the fight.
Got a gun. I fired him. Just fucking dog shit.
Nice. On you.
Yeah.
It's just a boring contest.
In terms of contest scores and our performance against them both recently and, you know, across the entire span of scrims, it's been pretty one-sided. I believe we've doubled their score on World's Edge in terms of contest results.
Taming the dogs.
And they still haven't left. And they say, high ping, that's why we're losing. Today, we 2-1 them, or 3-1 them, and they were like lower ping than us, so they have no excuse. However, they just don't leave. They're just, I don't know, stubborn, I guess.
The other option impact before it posted?
I think we've contested 100 games by now, but we've got the Ice Alliance contested on the Stormpoint, and it's looking good for the boys. I don't know why they haven't left. I think there's something wrong with them.
We believe that even though they'll be contesting at LAN, and that's what we expect from them because of that commitment that they have. We're comfortable performing whether they're contesting or not because we are so consistently coming out on top.
Chill, John. Push it.
Oh,
they got
testing?
Sit the
fuck down, pussy, you suck dick! My fucking POI, pussy!
That was...
Make
that,
sure cracking one next
was
time.
That even a fucking challenge? Come on. Come on, boys. And now they're trying to grief me. They're shooting me from like fucking ages away.
No, that's sweet.
Bye. Have fun spectating. You can learn something.
No, wait there.
The airport's soon. The airport's coming. Sorry.
Up just so they get courage to fight from the other two teams, and they were more than happy to do so. Big great plays for them. It's not looking like that's happening.
Ready to fucking smoke these dogs.
Jin's picking up this
guy, by the way.
Confidence. I'm gonna fight this shit, man.
Your brother's in the crowd. Are you excited to play in front of him for the first time?
Yeah, excited to play with the whole family, bro.
Jin? I love you. Whoa. You put your heart and soul into everything you do. And I know that you're going to put your very best into this. And that's all you need, okay? You smash it out.
Not good.
DZ in first place. Aurora playing well. They're both about to go head-to-head here.
Perhaps could you use a little help on that one? Okay, that's the one change we've seen to Harvester, of course, with that extra loot down the middle. It looks like Aurora are going to be the ones to grab some of that.
Hey, sometimes you just gotta get an alternator and get in on their melee for a little bit of a help. And just like that, you said it, Gino. Dark Zero was gonna be a little more hefty for them, but Aurora come out in style.
Aurora and DZ finally match up, and Aurora came out swinging. They decided to copy DZ's exact strategy. This change made it so, rather than both teams grabbing loot and then engaging, which was favoring Dark Zero as they were securing the gold loot down below, they would instead try to land on the exact loot that DZ was trying to grab, which made it much more of an RNG-based contest. And without the ping issues, contesting in a straight RNG drop such as this comes down to who has the better jump master and can reach the gold loot and bins first. In the first group stage matches, Aurora 3-0'd DZ.
And Aurora sticking it to DZ.
It's a 1v1. Jin Bird has already done 449 damage in this context.
You can deal all the damage you want, but it doesn't matter if you're not getting the eliminations. Jen, Burton, keep crawling forward, utilizing your shield from your teammate. But just go for the res. He might get it.
Okay, please, he has time to get that ultimate down. Oh. Is it enough? Oh, it went down to the last 25 health.
Ready for the contest?
You
guys send him back to the airport?
Fucking Malibon on Caustic, already on a purple, can just kind of throw those barrels out immensely, but Jen Burton equally running the Caustic.
A very valuable pick in a position like Harvester as well. A lot of chokes that you have to run through, so Caustic's value just gets quintupled even as we jump into the contest for this POI. Sense that the last one standing already, but he does have the assistance of Gas. With a little bit of body blocking, he almost makes it work, but Aurora bite the dust and Dark Zero take Harvester.
Copying DZ's strategy only continues to work if DZ fails to respond in the next two groups, but Dark Zero came to play later that day. They decided to adjust by consolidating their landing. While Zero would still go for the low ground, Jen Burton as Caustic would try and take control of the center of Harvester and lock it down with the Caustic barrels. If contested, Zero would then quickly queue back up to his teammate in the middle. This shift relied heavily on Zero's ability as the solo jumper to win the race to the middle in order to back up his team, and he showed up.
Three now two, DZ.
Holy
just
DZ.
Oh shit, here we go. Branch is landing right in the middle. Gets a wingman.
Oh, the Syracuse is big there. But Jen gets a one clip anyway.
That is a huge jet. That is a huge knock for Jen. No one even went in the middle here, bro. Cleave and them are going to be trying. Cleave's going to try to stay alive. DZ is moving different right now, bro.
Fresh can.
Fresh can of tough things, yeah. And Aurora is eliminated. And DZ go up 3-0. Aurora 3-0s DZ. DZ bounces back so hard that they go 3-0 against Aurora on the next set, 30 minutes.
Bye, Aurora.
You guys fucking 3-0 their set.
Yeah.
Did he start trying? No,
they were kidding. We did something different.
Yeah. And you guys cooked?
No loot. After
easy.
There is no point in 3-0.
What happened? You guys had your eyes closed the first set or what?
No, like that.
No, they're just idiots.
Straight up doing our shit.
Yeah, they just copied us the first year.
It's nice from my perspective because I know they have the ability and the past experience. It's more about they're one of, if not the best teams in Apex right now, and it's more about getting them to play up to that standard consistently, you know, being the players that they should be, because if they perform up to their levels, then they'll be winning pretty much everything they play.
How do you feel after your first day?
It's easy.
What about you?
Easy.
The biggest question mark in terms of Split 2 playoffs is really a combination of consistency and just general meshing as a team. We know they've been playing well through Pro League and winning regional finals in NA. So more so than anything else, it's about, you know, working with a new member with Zynu and then going into LAN with confidence, because like I said, they're some of the best players there, and if they play up to par, then they won't have an issue at all.
Day two, six games. We need 15 points today. Easily done, bro. It's like a rest day, honestly.
Yeah?
Yeah, mate. This bloody event's awesome, though. The crowd's bloody...
How many points do we need today?
Are you parents here? Yeah. 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 I think
I only have two ammo.
Nice.
Aurora are very low down the leaderboard. Aurora need to be having games like that every single time to give themselves a chance of getting into the winner's bracket. For Dark Zero, though, that might just be enough to put them in winner's bracket tomorrow already, which makes things a little bit scary when you go into World's Edge later, because it would, of course, be Dark Zero versus Aurora.
Who? DZ landing on Aurora at Shipfall.
What the fuck is going on? DZ goes to Aurora? They bring the contest?
I'm scanning, scanning, scanning. Where's my scan?
I look
armor.
Nice, that's good.
Let me heal. I think his armor's one. Check this, check this.
Nice, nice.
Bubble down, bubble down. Is there anything else? Two shots. Keep going. Top. Here, he knocked down.
Enemy.
He doesn't have a gun, he doesn't have a gun.
I have to reload.
Where is he? He might have a gun now. He doesn't have a gun still, Jeff.
DZ stands up, a little bit of a pop off there, and Aurora is eliminated by DZ.
You this like that little sneak attack play?
It's a little personal right now. It's all, I'm starting to feel things.
Watch it, enemy there.
I found Aurora. I found them. Here. In this building,
never
I swear
mind.
To God.
Let it go.
The comp.
Gibby Bank.
That is them.
And it's the Bangalore skin too. It's the
yeah, it's the Bangalore skin, I saw that.
Did we fucking interfight on them or what?
I mean, if they're alive, I think we just do, right?
I'm gonna die.
Oh no, pick inside. There's a guy
yeah, I can search scan.
Can we pick inside?
I'm search scanning.
Go inside, go inside.
Two branches. He's here at the moment, but it's Dark Zero who arrive, and Aurora eliminated again by Dark Zero. They have been the boogeymen.
Don't.
Reinforce
my God! And
oh
Jen
my
Perrin.
God!
Jen Perrin somehow stays alive. How is that even
possible?
Where's
Papa Jen? He's got to be hitting the moonwalk.
Papa Jen right now is probably 16 beers deep. What an absolute animal.
We gotta do something, yeah. Those guys suck.
Yeah, I think that'll be like the biggest thing is just like seeing people in front of me while I'm playing. Like a really big stage. But yeah, it's gonna be fun. I don't think I'm gonna be that nervous. It'll be cool.
Today, Aurora have finally left to the
dog
airport.
Shit.
The dog!
Otosan, NRG, Dark Zero, LG, Chivas, Pulverex, Fnatic, Oxygen, Alliance, TSM, and Moist. We will see you on Sunday.
If only they had the sum brain power, maybe they would have qualified. But they don't have any. Ranchers, you're an idiot. I hope you learn your life lesson, you dumbass. Now you're annoying champs. Mine is looking free.
Tomorrow's
it matters.
Yeah, all you need to know is that I'm literally telling
you.
Yeah, I don't even know what's going on because he's not showing it.
Nothing good?
Cavazino!
I'm feeling good. Tomorrow's what matters the most. Today didn't go as well as we wanted it to, but you know, we'll show up tomorrow. So.
Imagine.
Big storylines throughout all of this has been, can North America back-to-back? Can TSM do it yet again here in the same stadium that they did it in February? Coming down from the heavens, Hal certainly wishes he can get back TSM up there today.
Okay, of course, yeah, it's TSM.
It wouldn't be an Apex event if we didn't have TSM chance. I think we could genuinely not have TSM at the event, and we would still have TSM chance.
So here's the thing, you're saying DZ could surprise us all.
It's very possible, yeah.
Who's your biggest threat right now to win this tournament?
Yeah, if I had to rank like the biggest threats, I'd probably put Dark Zero number one.
Dark Zero!
Give me your top five in the end of this tournament. Who's going to be first, second, third, fourth, fifth?
We're going to win.
I want an order. You guys
are going to win.
Okay.
TSM second.
It's done! TSM up in the skies! How's going to
be champions here in London?
Champions here in London.
Go! Game one is on the way, chat.
Get it, baby.
This is game one of the match point.
Yeah,
I'm going.
TSM take game number one. They stand up, they pop off, the crowd goes wild. Big E doing it for Samantha.
Here for TSM if they can get them, but there's the Newcastle wall. The castle wall's a problem, but so is Verhulst. He's going in, but can't quite get the knock. There's the mobile shield, and TSM eliminated. Maybe to push.
Here we go.
The black hole goes down. Xainu's gonna swing. They're gonna go left. They're gonna look to tough them up. They're gonna look to put them to bed. Xainu moves in. It's a 2v1.
It's a 2v1 and it should just be easy from here, but the knockdown shield makes things a lot more difficult.
Xainu goes up onto height. Vayne left on his own, trying to do what he can. It would be a mesmerizing play if he could pull this off, but Jett's had time now to pop that battery. Send in Xainu. Send in Jett Burden. Send the victory screen towards Dark Zero, and Jen's up on the desk. Match point achieved for Dark Zero alongside a champion banner.
Over to the side, nice cover. Curly C on the other side. Skittle Cake now taking a different angle to prevent Verhulst. TSM get eliminated.
Res maybe.
They res. Runner.
Five! Push it, push it, push it!
Still alive! Dark Zero get deleted out of the lobby as FaZe move in!
Holding, don't holding! One guy.
One of the squads in the lobby that have been at match point now taken out. Dark Zero meet their doom alongside Imperial Hal. The black hole gets called in. He's trying to dance around. He's forced to go into the circle, the gravity lift to take him up. He's taking so much damage off the health alone.
Can what feel like a game six? We're going again!
Outside, no one's inside, all outside. Barely any HP to play with as well. Vayne is going to be the man who gets it. Auction in Esports, who just got onto match point, will take out Dark Zero. They will not win it.
It's a battle of North America in the final circle.
and someone's going to have to take down one of their regional friends if they want this tournament to keep going. Now TSM will be forced off a fight, and they might get pushed here because there will be a grab lift behind them. They're going to get queued behind, and it's Exen! It's Exen! They take out TSM! But now Reps and Imperial Hal have to do it to keep their chances of winning in this game alive. 100 Thieves are on one side, Gambari Otazan on the other side. TSM are getting sandwiched, and Reps is the last remaining player here. And 100 Thieves are doing so much damage from the high ground. Can Reps bite the time? No! TSM fall!
Right, 2 seconds of wall.
Yeah.
I'm on the wall in the second.
I've been calling you.
Not fine, it's probably off. Excuse me. We've been waving this all week. We're at zero. Oh, Rui.
Yo! Celebration.
It may not be a hug, it have to be. Well done, sweetheart. It's a great job.
3, 2, 1.
Well done, mate. Mission accomplished. Really, really, really good. Now you know what pressure is like, and you know you can handle it. You can perform, but you can perform under pressure. But that's what a team is about. But you can perform under pressure, and that is not an easy thing to learn.
I'm not going to be able to sleep tonight.
Oh no, that's just cool.
Oh my god.
About the game. How are you doing? You're
amazing. Oh my god. We did it.
Incredible.
I stink probably.
Yeah, I don't think so. Oh. Yeah, it sucks to be a DZ. There's too many of them, but goddamn it sucks.
What about the Booyers?
It's the boys. Shout out.
Like, give me a voice as I knew.
He's the goat. I don't think anyone else in a position would have done the same. It's like the best work ethic. Really good mental, and just insane to play CF for like a month and then win that on top ragging as well.
Get the clip, he said something positive about a teammate.
Yeah. I've been saying that in all interviews, I'm sucking on Vanu. Time to get fucked.
Yeah, 3-time champion, 2-time MVP, how does it fucking feel?
getting a bit boring these days. Might be time to hang it up. I don't know. Or switch to roller.
Could you have imagined it any other way?
No. I think we were going to win the whole time. My teammates are too good. I honestly thought we were going to win since the beginning. The entire time. I was nervous like the first like game, but after that, I was pretty... Because like the first game wasn't hard at all, and I was like, wow, Len just is the same thing as Pro League. So I just was way more confident after that. When we were on match point, people were like, as soon as we died, they're like, yeah, like, let's go. And then as soon as we won, people were like, go TSM. And I was like, all right. And then when I first joined Dark Zero before regionals, I had so much hate, and they were like, everyone's like praying on Dark Zero's downfall. And then we all did good. So, I mean, I guess I don't mind it.
It feels great to be back being the best in the world again. Like, just gonna keep doing it.
Finals, I told the boys that just forget about the past, move on to the finals. It's where it all matters. And yeah, we just did the job. Yeah. Past 2 months, probably the best Apex I've ever played in my life. And I feel like I played really bad in Split 1, but that's because I moved to America and I was genuinely like kind of depressed for 3 months. I didn't know what to do. There's no family. I've got no friends really around me, a whole new area. I'm like 30 minutes away from the city. So I didn't know what to do. I was just like huddled up inside the room, just doing, I barely streamed. It was just boring and just depressed. Yeah. So right now I go out with Evan. I go out with more people. I do gym. So I feel more confident myself. So for the kids out there, grinding and having passion is all that matters. I knew I could do this job. I knew I could be a pro player. So I just kept doing it. I just kept going for my dream. And that's what you guys should be doing too.
Yeah, you mentioned Zainu. You know, how has he been? What's it been like taking him through, you know, by far the biggest tournament of his career? How quickly has he adapted to be on Dark Zero?
I think he really pretty much is the perfect teammate. Like a lot of these kids, you know, they get a shot, it's their first lane, they want to be arrogant, not listen to you. Like, they get a big shot and then they just relax. But he is the hardest worker in the scene. But all he does is listen, he never argues, and he's just being a perfect teammate. The most important thing for me, honestly, is just tying Hal, beating Hal. That's all that's left to beat. Everyone else is like not really close, but tying Hal again, getting another MVP as well. Does he have two? Oh, might be beating him now in the record.
Now just championships. You guys gonna win that one as well?
And might actually get four, beat Hal, I don't know. Could be fun.